Hello, my name is Brian Campbell, and I am the Director of the Bureau of Curriculum, Assessment, and Instruction at the Pennsylvania Department of Education. I'd like to thank you for taking the time to join us today and for your interest in PDE's local assessment data analytics. The purpose of today's session is to provide an overview that will prepare you and your leadership team to participate in this critical upcoming project. Meeting individual student needs and providing appropriate instructional supports is of the highest priority. Unfinished teaching and learning, increased economic hardships, and trauma have negatively impacted student learning, exacerbating existing achievement gaps and introducing new ones. At the same time, the cancellation of statewide assessments during the 2019-20 school year and the extension of testing windows for the 2021 school year mean that local assessment systems will take on added importance in navigating the educational and other harms of the past year. PDE is designing a system through which LEAs can voluntarily submit local assessment data and receive analytics similar to traditional Pennsylvania growth reports normed to PA performance levels. Reports and data tools in this format will be consistent with the analytics provided on state assessment scores. LEAs may submit any local assessment data. Popular examples include, but are not limited to, the CDT, STAR, NWEA MAPS, iReady, DIBBLES, Acadience, and AIMS web assessments. The results can potentially aid LEAs in measuring unfinished teaching and learning that may have resulted from pandemic mitigation efforts. In addition to traditional PA growth and performance data, we are working with the IUs to design and deliver professional development in assessment literacy, local assessment planning, and data analysis and decision making, and will be providing resources for LEAs to use in completing future local assessment plans, communication plans, and comprehensive planning documents. We encourage all LEAs to take part in this unique opportunity. Once data is submitted, PDE and local intermediate units will provide data tools and comprehensive support to assist LEAs in increasing the understanding of the impacts of COVID-19 in LEAs and schools, assessing current learning trends among students, evaluating whether different groups of students experience different learning outcomes during school interruptions, and identifying the amount of learning needed to get students back on track to their pre-pandemic expected achievement levels. It's important to know that local assessment data will not be publicly reported, nor will the data be utilized for any accountability or evaluative purposes. This data would serve as an internal resource for LEAs to use to guide decision-making, resource allocation, and program design at the school and LEA level. PDE would use only state-level aggregate totals to design the resources and professional development. By leveraging existing local assessments and receiving student growth and performance data, schools can apply critical insights to identify inequities in academic progress and proactively design scaffolded systems to ensure all students are effectively supported in accessing and mastering grade level standards. LEAs may submit data derived from vendor, textbook, or locally developed assessments and receive the following in the fall of 2021. LEA-specific summaries, including summary statistics such as standard deviation, quantile percentiles, and correlation summaries. State-level summaries, including summary information on each assessment, distributions of available test scores by test, subject, and grade, and correlations among all tests, subjects, and grades. Through a survey given in cooperation with the PAIU Curriculum Council, work has already begun on the most popular assessments across the Commonwealth. For these assessments and others that meet the project's technical criteria, the following additional information will be available in the fall of 2021. LEA and school PVAS growth measures for a specific subject, grade, and time period. Student learning analysis to determine the impact of COVID-19 on student learning by comparing students' expected scores based on their pre-pandemic performance with their observed scores based on their most recent performance, and aggregating the difference to various student groups. Growth measures indicate how students' achievement has changed relative to national norms or the average growth of test takers across the state, and it can provide valuable information about a student's growth. This analysis can provide insight into which student groups, grades, and/or subjects have been most impacted by the pandemic. With empirical data in hand, based on their own students, LEAs can target resources toward their students who need the most assistance, address inequities in student learning, and establish a recovery plan for students and the LEA. LEAs may submit local assessment data through the PIMS Student Local Assessment Subtest template in May and June of 2021. There is no process in which an LEA must sign up or report its intent to participate to the department. All LEAs who submit data will receive reporting and access to the deliverables. Data is collected through the Local Assessment Performance and Growth PIMS collection in the Student Local Assessment Subtest template. A reporting window will open for approximately 6 weeks from mid-May to late June to allow LEAs time to complete their locally scheduled assessments. The submission is voluntary, but we encourage all LEAs to participate. The template is similar to the alternate assessment template for grade 3 reading and grade 7 math, but they are separate, independent submissions. Again, local assessment data will not be added to public websites such as the Future Ready PA Index or ESSA report card. In the student local assessment template, you'll tell us about how each student performed on an assessment and identify the student by their PA Secure ID. PDE will use that ID match to pull any other student demographics from the appropriate student snapshot. To prepare for the submission, you'll need the information about the assessment, which assessment is being reported, the subject area, the student's grade level at the time of testing, the component being measured, the type of scoring being reported, and the score. PDE will define for you what values can be reported based on the test description and the subject area. We have partnered with PAIU to design and deliver a professional learning series to assist LEAs in designing and maintaining a quality local assessment system for years to come. These synchronous course sessions are part of PDE's Accelerated Roadmap series and will offer Act 45 credit to leaders regardless of whether they participated in the voluntary submission. Session topics, which will be held in August of 2021, include assessment literacy and designing local assessments, creating a local assessment plan, and data analysis protocols and communicating student progress to families and caregivers. Additionally, LEAs who participate in the project can attend additional supports and trainings in November that will dive into the analysis and interpretation of growth and performance reports provided by the state and its partners. Intermediate units will assist LEAs in addressing impacts to teaching and learning due to pandemic-related interruptions based on the needs of Pennsylvania's students providing resources and trainings that include a regional and statewide scan of local assessments to LEA level administrators for networking and training purposes, professional development in assessment literacy, local assessment planning, and data analysis and decision making, resources for LEAs to use in completing future local assessment plans, communication plans, and comprehensive planning documents, and data tools for analysis of specific local assessments and growth and trend data for impacts on teaching and learning. The IUs will also provide technical assistance for LEAs throughout the scope of the local assessment project. Remember, no registering with the department is necessary. Simply enter data into PIMS during the May-June window to participate. Additional supports include Data Quality Network Q&A sessions in May and PIMS open office hours throughout June. Leaders may participate in the Act 45 local assessment modules in August, and growth and performance reports will be returned to schools in fall of 2021. Additional data team sessions and open office hours will be held in November. PDE will continue to release guidance and resources, including sample reports, over the coming weeks. Be on the lookout for upcoming e-messages and check our website for updates. If you have questions about the local assessment programming, please contact the Bureau of Curriculum, Assessment, and Instruction at the email address on this slide. For assistance with data entry and PIMS, please contact the PA Secure ID Help Desk. Thank you for your interest in the local assessment project, and we look forward to partnering with you in this critical work. All of us at the department appreciate your dedication and leadership during these unprecedented times.